So this is getting drier, it's not totally dry. Here is, so I might just work on that up in the top of the roof. But I just want to add a little bit more of a darker tone in here by going straight in to this neutral tint. Quite a dry mixture with this number 12 brush. Just popping in while this is still slightly moist. And then it'll just blend itself down. While that's still wet. I know it's a green door, but it's looking more like an opening now. The thing that bothered me on reflection was that this green and this green, it was all kind of clashing a bit. So just gonna pop in there. Put in some burnt umber as well. Touch. This is still damp in places. End of the brush look. Loose control. Loose, I said, not loose. Loose sort of brown notes. There's very strange beam work. It really does look like in the original, though. It's kind of gonna collapse any day soon. So this is just taking in we'll leave some pencil work obviously showing. This is just coming out with some of the outlines. And while this is damp, you're going to get blended and bleeding going in, which is quite nice, but what we don't want to do is go too crazy with it. Variety. So then I'll go in with a smaller brush, the number 2. Same sort of mixture really, the burnt umber. These buildings have kind of little crosses on them as part of the a bleeder note. That'll be quite nice not to have everything sharp. It's a nice dry brush. Just like exercising the strain. It's like, oh, gonna draw here, gonna draw there. But actually, the only really annoying things about these travel brushes is in them they gather water, and there's a hole at the end. You can see that hole, and it, if it's been left inside your water, it sort of sucks up and drops out now and again, which is really annoying when you're trying to paint. than that. Oh, great little brush. There we go. It's still the burnt umber, just warming a few things up, really. Well, that's liquid there, that's quite nice. A lot of this is liquid, probably quite early to be putting these lines in, but you'll get the blending and bleeding. We talked about earlier, some of it will be sharp lines, others will be blurred in lines. We'll still come in with some sharper lines. Some dry brush over here and here. Just to join up some of these. Probably going to leave this in the background. I could start painting in tree trunks and things, but I'm just going to leave it as a sketchy sort of feel on that. It's quite nice. It's just a scratch out. Kind of getting there. So roof dry, yes. Light bit of detail. We could leave this pencil work, or we could pop it in with some brush. We've got a brush. Sort of the thinking time now. What am I doing? Why am I doing it? Do I need to do it? When we get to this point in the painting, we're getting near to a finish. It's like, does it add value or not? Is it best just to leave it sparse as it is? I need to sort this out here. Moment, it's all working quite well. So I think I'm just going to stop for the moment and have a little reflect on what I need to do next. So this is now nice and dry. Finish it off with time to think about this now. It's quite a large painting, half imperial size. Just going back and looking at my value sketch. Just popping in some of those. I quite like the feel of the sketch at the moment, though. I don't want to go too mad. So my real decision is to, I've kind of got the outlines that I needed, so I'm happy enough with that. Just a bit of dry burnt umber. And just down in here, I like the way this is sort of blended and bled here, just signify some sharper edges here. darker in places, not much. These are like subtleties, really. And the next thing I'm going to do is go through and sort out the shadows. So I want some nice strong shadow mix, so this burnt amber will be fine with some ultramarine going in there. It's a kind of grey mixture plus some alizarin or alizarin crimson, whichever way you want to do it. And I'm just going to go darker. I've been thinking about this. I do like the, what I've got here in terms of shadows. They're quite subtle, but I just want to bring them in a bit darker, and especially in here. Okay, that one works quite well. There's also a shadow coming off of there. Behind there, the light's hitting, and there's I'm just going to move that up to bleed that back in. And then I'll slightly warm this one up here with some more alizarin crimson in it. And what I'll do on the end here is I might just run off a touch of water in this. Now this is in here, I don't like that anymore. There was a patch that wasn't in shadow, but it's kind of annoying now, so we'll run this off.